just did a couple breakout trades pre-market. Pre-market's where it's at. Now I'm watching. These two stocks are doing the exact same thing. So, which one has more volume, I guess? Both have volume. I think SCKT has more volume. Interesting. Look at that break below VWAP. Look at it pop back up. This is dangerous. I shouldn't have held into the open because I keep on forgetting when the market does open. Oh, this is pumping. $4, $4.25. I see. Oh, that's pumping like crazy. Okay, well, how did I miss that? It's time to play. Okay, so it's taking a flush. Shift one. Maybe. I don't know whatever that bottom is. Oh, it's curling. Just took a starter. 16, I'm out. Didn't curl. First candle to make a new high. Wow, it's going nutso. Well, that's flushing out. Maybe. Get rid of these fucking graphs. Good idea. My aptitudes. Wow. Okay, are we curling? Maybe we could get back in at 4:30. First candle to make a new high on the 10-second. Okay, we're curling back up, so let's take a starter. Just see some green on the tape. Key contains valid, unvalid quantity, huh? Just saw some green on the tape. So, take 100 share starter. I'm gonna stop here at 401. It's 20 cents, but it's a very small amount, so. Flush out. I'm watching. But yeah, I flushed out. So just like that, I lost $52. And I'm break even now on the day. Man, I had a little profit cushion. That didn't work out. Gave me false confidence. And I lost money. Well, this thing kind of is over. Bounce off VWAP, maybe? Whoa, that broke way below VWAP. Girl. break a VWAP. No. False. I think it was just a tiny little starter. A break a VWAP is sucky. Watch it, but it breaks it now. Okay, well, wow, that lost all its momentum. Another false breakout on VWAP. Just can't break that VWAP. Just struggling. Break even, and now I'm in the hole. This whole breaking VWAP thing sucks. I do not do well. Dogs. Dogs. Stops halted. I don't believe it. That's doing well. Instant resolution. Expecting instant resolution. I'm going to add there. And I'm going to add at the break of 350. It's not as strong as I thought, but I'm gonna add here. Boom. 330. Oh, I'm so grateful for the simulator. But look, I've already lost 100 bucks. GG. Wow, that's doing terrible. But I'll halt it. The volume on that really sucks. Okay, let's see, TC. Yeah. Wow, it's just being slow. It's not fun. Dobbs is one of our gappers. K-V-L-N-O-E-V-K. Let's check the EVK. Let's check that out. Down $100. Get back in right there. Baby. Things are so slow moving. They suck. S-C-K-T. Scrolling back to you, could be favorite stock just halted. Holy bras. It's time to make back my money. Yeah. When did that halt? Actually halted 9:42. Okay, I'm freezing my balls off. I'm going to turn down my AC. Okay. I say halted at 9:42. It will resume at 9:57 and 45 seconds. Orders, are you ready? Nope. Let's check this guy out. Could break me wet. Casing. Bye, lady. What do you want to go for? Maybe the $6? Gaps and gaps. It has a potential to go to 13, huh? It could resume at any minute now. Let's see, 604, huh? That's a bad fill. Can't break six, eh? Oops. Six, eh? Good thing this is not real money, but like still. This was so choppy, but I was able to make some. This is choppy over six. False breakouts after that. Okay, break the VWAP. 587. flush like that, below the view app, I'm not interested. Space it says at 34. Step out. Okay, we made back some profit there. As far as you want to dip this? Not really. On the curls, curling back up. So grateful for simulator and fake money. Massive volume, low fault. Okay, did Kishin ever resolve? Oh, now it's bouncing? Way below the view app. Not interested. ZDGE. Below the view app, not interested. SCKT. Daily breakout, massive volume, low flow. This has got momentum, maybe. Still above the free web. First candle to break a new high. Oh, there it is. Sort of. It's 410. Take a position at 4. Let's go. 4-6. Holding that for support, so safe there, but as soon as that drops, I'm out, because it's going to flush. I really couldn't break that 410. It's red to green move. I should wait till it actually breaks 410. Okay, it's flushing out. Oh, yep. Ah, bounce of VWAP. Okay, I see ya. You bouncing up? $380 is a resistance, and we're buying up. We're buying up. This looks weak. Buyers. collected. Right there. Aggressive on this. Yeah, permission granted. Like, go be aggressive. Buy these dips, buy these micro pullbacks right here. Let it pull back to the EMA. You know, let it. Just gotta get a feel for how strong this is, you know? There's a pullback. Seeing some. Red, 62, 64, okay, it's curling up, I'm gonna buy this at 564, okay, stop, 550, scale in here. Six. Let's take some profit. Six, give me six. Yep, six. Let's go. Take half that. And I think I'm gonna be out if I'm negative. Nope. Eighty-seven, 82. Well, let's get out of that. Step by. Dude. Permission to be a little more aggressive. We got a profit cushion. Well, on the stock at least. Still pumping. 80, we're going negative. Can it hold 80? Yep, I held 80. Oh, how did I go at 590? Good question. It's taking a break. bit. Thank you. look at those doji. Doji says it all. Says reversal. This is a good price. No. Duh. No, duh. Bounce off VWAP, baby. 277. Just gonna do a big tap. goodness. Thank you. 18 has a lot of resistance. It's resistance. That's why they call it resistance. I'm just revenge trading. Revenge trading! Thank you. volume here. It's not popping. Nothing's happening on this guy. It's dead. super bad at these dip trades. squeeze up to three. There's your stop. 15 cents. Profit here. Didn't break out like I expected it to. Break of 320. Let's go. Nope. I like how it broke that. Break 285 and hold 280 as support. not curling up, and it's not resolving. Okay, now we got some curl. Some curl action on 285. Money on SNES. $53. Yeah. Things are very slow now. It's CKD. Alrighty, so Cappage. Five-minute daily. How do I pan? Oh, like that? Okay. Alright. So, this was our only profitable trade. So, looks like I bought 250 at 3, sold at 330 because I thought it was a flush, bought at 308, sold because I saw it going up, I sold at 312 and 323. Profitable trade, half-half right there, so not bad. How did I, let's see, 250, sell at 125. So obviously, I was still in, still had some. I bought again at 308, so I was looking for the break of 310. Got sold at 312 because I was like, oh, it's breaking. Immediate sell. 323. Sold again. Somehow I managed to get the top of that. Even though I was like, I'm in profit. I need to sell pronto, and it's my first day. And just like that, I made $50 for the beginning of the day pre-market. Probably shouldn't have held into opening bell, but I was watching it pretty close, so but yeah, there were some opportunities here, like this one right here to get in, and you know, with a 10 cent stop, get in somewhere around here, sell up here, make some good profit. Okay, so next is SCKT. Obviously, I overtraded this. Look at this. And you can tell every trade was kind of like, at least I'm getting at where the volatility is, but. Okay. I think it was up at the beginning of the day. So, I bought high, I sold low, stopped out. So I was going up, bought for the squeeze of 420, up to 424, had to stop out. Not really a good trade. 4 was psychological resistance. I was feeling the FOMO. I was looking at the break of 410. Did not give the momentum I wanted. So I was up on the day. I decided to do some dip trades. So I bought here, got scared. I bought here again, had to sell. This was really bad. 369 to 350. 10 cent stop, whatever. Okay, so this was pretty good. Bought 378, bought at 390, bought at 4, sold here, sold and sold. I bought again right here for the break, but could not get it, so I sold here, sold here. So this looks like a profitable trade. Looks like it. Then I started revenge trading after that. I was like, I can do this and buy, sell, buy, buy, sell, buy, sell. So you can see I'm trying to buy these dips, and you know, if I buy, I mean, 100 shares is nothing. So as soon as it popped back up, I was not taking any profit. And on top of that, not breaking even because it was only 100 shares. I sold down for a loss of 382, 358, so, well, like 25 cents? Not that great. So I was profitable, but when it spikes up, I'm profitable, but this spike was a definitely huge breakthrough of VWAP. This was a false breakout of VWAP. Did not take. Another break of VWAP. So this was like a VWAP day, and I did not realize that. So yeah, I lost on these and these. They were terrible. Look at me trying to revenge trade down here. No, revenge trade down here. So if I just stop revenge trading these dips, I think I'd, and just focus on the breakouts, I think I would do much better. And again, only revenge trade when you're up on the day, I think. Other than that, I gotta stay away from those dip trades. So that's how I lost 272, I just kept on dip buying. Dogs. I'm down $36 here. So I'm buying 100 and 100. I don't know why I'm buying 100. I think I'm using the shift 1 key. And then I bought right here. And then I had to sell. And then I had to sell 100 down here. So I don't know what pattern. I may be breaking all the highs. Maybe that's why I was doing 100s, because it's risk adverse. But I needed to take that 10 cent profit right there. I was looking for a lot bigger move. Just did not move like I had expected it to, and I didn't move for the rest of the day, so I really missed that opportunity. LEDs I saw on the Momo scanner. This is terrible. I was just checking it out. Such a bad stock. Keshin, I was up on the day on this guy. So, here is, let's turn this music down because it's getting a little too poppy. So this was very interesting, and I think I made some money and lost some. So I bought 100 shares, come on. So I'm very confident, but I bought the break of 6, sold at 605 and 616. So I'm buying and selling around 6. As soon as it started dropping, I started these dip trades for a break of VWAP. I never made it. So I gotta stop doing these. Well, that's the hard thing, because Ross says you can take a dip trade on VWAP, but it's a more advanced strategy. Unless I'm up on the day, I think I better stay away from those, because that's when I lose. So it did bounce off VWAP and pull back. But these were very fast, and I did not time it right. You see I'm using 250 shares, I should be using less. I sold here, I bought here, it was terrible. Keshin. I started out profitable on Keshin too. With such a little share size, I didn't really make that much. So I must have not been grateful for that. Clips. I think this was just a okay, clips. Okay. So why did I buy here? I noticed it was gaining some momentum. It was breaking the half dollar. So I did, and this was a dip trade off the EMA right here, and it actually worked. So, but it had some good momentum, so I decided to take a trade right here. Sold at four, wow, that's 17 cents. But again, saw that it was pulling back, so I bought off the EMA again. Sold here. Wow, how am I down on this? Actually, I'm up. Okay, so I bought here, I sold some up here, bought again. Sold up here half, sold more, bought at 595. So I was just kind of buying as it went up and selling. I sold a big chunk here at almost $6 when it broke $6. Then I started to buy dips on the way back down. And then after a certain point, I was like, you know what? It's flushing out, and I'm out. So when I stopped doing these dip trades, I started winning. I feel like these dip trades work when it's going up, and they don't when they go down. So if I were to cut out the dip trades, I think it would have been profitable, maybe. Okay, so bought up here, sold for a profit, wow, 250, bought here at 250 at 3, another 3, sold all of it at 291, so not bad. Buy, sell up here, buy. Okay, so you took a big loss here when it flushed down. So why did you get in this trade? I saw it was moving up. It had broken some good resistance. I tried dip trading, didn't work. Checked out. Wait for it to crawl back up. It broke this level. I did a bunch of trading right here. Just trying to predict this move, but it just would not go. End up losing and then revenge trading a little bit down here. Just could not predict this thing. After it broke $3, I was trying to get in at 320, buy, just keep on selling. Hey, look, these are like pretty significant losses. I didn't have any buildup, so I just could not take off from that level. Which is sad, but that's where I lost all my money, is trying to get that prediction out of there. So, lots of busyness here, just $100. 100 shares. Thank God it was only 100 shares. Alright. CDR. Didn't do much. Although it popped, I just wasn't interested. EVK, some great action. through 70 point was a pivotal point. Actually, I'm up on EVK, so I bought here at 360. Dip trade. Got confident at 370. Sold. 375 for the breakout. That's exactly what I'm supposed to do. Sold again at 366 for a loss, but then had some trades up. Expecting the move up to 4. Never made it to 4. Sold out of this. Ended up being profitable all night. Actually, no. I lost $18, so made a mistake then and there. Wow. Can I just see that this last one was pretty compelling. And I went at it hard. I stepped up to the plate, as what Ross would say. So just kept on buying and selling. Buying. Buy. 280. 291. 3. Sold half, $3. Buy again, sell half. Just kept on doing the same thing, and then on the way down, tried to do some dip trades, didn't work. Gotta cut this dip trading out. So, if you look at my most profitable trades, what worked? The gap and go strategy worked. Probably what I should focus on. This is actually the break of the 1 minute candle. Sold half like I should have. Bought more when I saw it was going up. Sold into resistance like I should have. That was profitable. So this was a good recap. We had CLPS, which is extremely profitable, and I think if we keep implementing these strategies, cut out the dip trading and revenge trading after it flushes, unless you've got a profit on the day and you're willing to give up some, but I think that's the biggest takeaway.